Hi there, welcome back to our channel. Today, we will show you all the techniques to create a math crossword puzzle with ActivePresenter 8. This is a game that helps players enhance their mathematical thinking and calculation skills in a fun way. In this game, players are required to fill in the blank cells to make equations true. After finishing, click the Submit button. If there is any incorrect answer, players can review and check the results. From here, they can make corrections for the incorrect answers. If they give all the correct answers, the game is over. Now, let's get started. The steps to create this game include: insert objects to create the game layout, create crosswords, set up blank cells, submit and get results, and preview and export the game. Now, let's fill the slide with an image. In the background image section of the slide properties tab, choose an image from your computer. Then, to create the instruction, you navigate to the insert tab, select text caption. Feel free to change its font and size the way you want. The next step is to create horizontal and vertical crosswords. To get them done, you will take advantages of the grid box feature. Click the drop-down arrow on the container, select grid box. Click on the green plus button here to add cells for a crossword. Because of the 5 cells for an equation, you need to insert 5 shapes. Note that, the more cells your crossword contains, the more shapes you need to insert. After that, navigate to the properties pane of the grid box container. In the container layout section, set the number of column to 5. To get 5 square cells, you can change the exact size of the grid box in the transform section here. Then, navigate to its style and effects tab, set no fill and solid line. Adjust the width of the line as you wish. That is for creating a horizontal crossword. To create a vertical one, you can copy a horizontal crossword created earlier and paste it into the canvas. Access the size and properties tab of this pasted crossword. In the container layout section, reset the number of column to 1. And readjust the size to 100 pixels wide and 500 pixels high, for example. Now, it's time to combine them together to get a complete crossword puzzle. Once you move a grid box over the other, its container will turn orange due to the container snapping mode turned on by default. When you release the mouse button, their layouts will be snapped together like this. To turn this snapping mode off, simply access the View tab and click Container Snapping. After that, you can freely place crosswords anywhere on the slide. For a complete crossword puzzle, just copy and paste to create as many crosswords as you need. To change the text style inside crosswords at once, you can select all first. Next, access the Home tab and change text font, size, and color as you wish. It's easy to add numbers into the crosswords. You can also add math symbols right within ActivePresenter. To to insert a math symbol into a cell, you need to select that cell first. Next, open the Insert tab, click Equation. You can choose all necessary symbols to insert at once. Then, use the copy, cut, and paste commands to reuse them. Here's what you got. We are going to come to the next step, set up blank cells. Blank cells are cells you need to fill in to complete the equations. To set their correct answers, scores, attempts, etc., you can use the text entry object. Delete the default feedback messages if you don't need them. Change the size of the text entry object to be equal to the size of the blank cell. Navigate to the Style and Effects tab, set No Fill and No Line. Open the Home tab to change its text font, size, color, and Align Text Center. Place the customized text entry object on top of a blank cell. Now, you come to the Interactivity tab of the text entry to set its correct answer. In the General section, click Add Value and type the correct value for the equation. In the Score and Reporting section, make sure you use the default graded mode. Take notice of the point that players will get if they answer correctly. This point will be added to the App Quiz Score variable to be used for conditional actions in the later step. Change the attempts to infinite so that there is no limit on the number of answers that players can make. Set the submit method to auto for automatically submitting the answers. There are 8 blank cells, so you need 7 text entry objects more. Just use the copy and paste commands. Place the pasted one on top of each blank cell. Don't forget to adjust its corresponding correct answer. Perform the same steps to create other text entry objects. Submit and get results are the core steps to make the game work. To submit answers, open the Insert tab to insert a Submit button. Style it if needed. Navigate to its Events Actions section. Add the on-click event. Add the Show Responses action if there is any incorrect answer. With this action, you can show check marks for correct and incorrect answers, with the condition that the value of the App Quiz Score variable is less than 8. Besides, add the Show Feedback Layer action if players give all the correct answers. That means the value of the App Quiz Score variable is equal to 8. If you want to customize the feedback layer, just access the View tab, choose Feedback Master. To speed up your work, you can make changes in the Feedback Master layout first. Then, make adjustments in any layers the way you want. Moreover, add the replay button to let players retry the game. With the help of the on-click event, and the Restart Presentation action. Close the Feedback Master view. And now the game is almost done. Regarding showing check marks, you get a tip here. To make the game more appealing, you can reduce the width of all text entry objects a little bit, so that the answer filled in, and the check mark will be in the same cell. That's all. You have walked through all the techniques to create a math crossword puzzle with ActivePresenter 8. Before actually exporting the game, you can preview to see how it works. Finally, export the game to HTML5, SCORM, XAPI packages, depending on your needs. Hope it will help. See you later.